last but not least, Gemara Masechet Yoma, page 22, says, any sage who does not take revenge like a serpent is not considered a true Talmid Chacham. So this Gemara is very, very interesting because in one way it seems like it's contradicting everything we just said up to this point. On one end, you're telling us, be respectful for your fellow. One of the things that's required is to not be angry. Revenge only happens if you're angry. Then it says, do tshuva. If you're doing revenge, you're going to have to do tshuva. You're not even starting with the tshuva. Then it says, be close to the talmidim chachamim, but be careful from them. But it says here that if you don't take revenge, you're not a talmid chacham. So this whole thing, this gemara in Masechet Yoma, just takes everything we just learned for the last however much time we've been talking and turns it all upside down. So what does it really mean? A serpent, snake, was the first thing that was ever created that actually committed the first sin. The first sin that ever happened in the world was from the snake, the serpent. What was the sin? Lashon hara against God. It wasn't the sin of Adam and Eve eating from the tree of knowledge. That was the first sin. That was the next sin. The first sin, the original sin, was the serpent saying to Chava, saying to Eve, oh, God doesn't want you to eat from the tree of knowledge because he's scared. And look, he said, don't touch the tree. Look, you just touched the tree. God never said you can't touch the tree. He said, just don't eat from it. So he said, Lashon hara, made up stories about God. And this is the reason why Hashem cursed them with the worst possible curse in the Torah. He called them Arur. Arur means cursed. This is also something that if you look at the Parashat Bechukotai and Kitavo and a few other places in the Torah, when we are actually, when the Shvatim, when the tribes are in two different mountains, they say, blessed is the person that does XYZ, and then the other ones are saying, on the other mountain saying, Arur, cursed is the man that does XYZ. One of the things that someone gets the cursed, just like the snake, is by doing a sin in hiding. Meaning, he tells everybody he's a tzaddik, but in reality, he goes home and watches TV on Shabbat. Or he tells everyone he's a tzaddik, but in reality, he's stealing from his employees, or he's stealing from someone else. That person is Arur. Someone that actually canceled the Shiur Torah without a valid reason is considered Arur also. So nonetheless, being Arur was a big deal. The serpent was Arur. The snake was Arur. But part of that curse was that from that moment on, not only is he not going to be the king of all the animals, because originally he was supposed to be the king. The job was then given to the lion. But not only is he not going to be the most beautiful animal, not only is he not going to be the king of the animals, not only is the woman always going to hate the snake unless she's extremely unusual. Like in today's generation, some women like snakes, but in general, women hate snakes. Not only that, he's never going to have the pleasure of tasting food for what it is, because everything will taste to him like sand. That's the real curse. So Chazal in the Gemara Masechet Yoma said, a Torah sage who doesn't take revenge like a serpent is not considered a Talmid Chacham. The Baal Shem Tov says, gives the Pirush on this. Says, the result of God's curse, the serpent tastes everything like dust. And he has no pleasure from anything he eats. Whether it's a rat, or it's pizza, or it's a piece of metal, everything tastes the same. A true Talmid Chacham, similarly, reacts sharply only when one scorns the honor of the Torah, and not out of pleasurable sense of a personal vendetta. Like the serpent, his hiss is deadly, but he derives no pleasure from his bite. Talmid Chacham, he sees someone desecrating the Torah, going against Hashem, doing something that's mamash against the Torah, he must stand firm. He must go against it. He can't sit there like a little tatale waiting for things to stop. He sees Chilul Hashem happening, he must fight it. Every one of us has to be a little bit of Pinchas. You can't just sit there and say, oh, no, it's somebody else will take care of it. If that's Hashem's will, it's Hashem's will. What's Hashem's will? Hashem's will is to bring a missionary to a synagogue. Hashem's will is to convert people to Christianity. Hashem's will is to desecrate the Torah. No, that's not Hashem's will. That's the Yetzer Hara's will. You have to do something about it. So Tamid Chacham is going to fight, but he's not going to enjoy the fight. He's not going to enjoy the fact that there's a bunch of fools saying they're going to donate to a church. He's not going to enjoy that people made such a horrible mistake, and now anyone that has a little bit of a brain is questioning their overall ideology. He's not enjoying this. He's not enjoying it, but he must do it. He must do it because he is a Talmid Chacham. He's not enjoying it because, just like the serpent was not allowed to enjoy his food, he is being known here and mentioned here as being like a serpent. That's the trait of the serpent that Talmid Chacham has to take. Not enjoying the fight, but knowing that he has to do it. Any questions? Baruch Adonai Leolam. Amen ve'amen.